Please welcome on stage, Sven Ditz.
Good morning, Niels. Good morning, Niels community. How do you feel? No, the question was not how do you like WordPress? Maybe again. How do you feel? Okay, thank you very much. I would like to welcome you. I would be your host for today and just moderating a little bit the talks. And yeah, to say hello here in Northern Germany, it's moin moin for the foreign people from Romania, from Russia, from Austria, from Switzerland, from Denmark, Bavaria. Thank you. He stole my joke. Yeah. We are very proud to have here the first official NEOS conference, the conference from the NEOS project. And we choose the location from just from the outfit. It looks a little bit like the former conferences in Kolbermoor. And yeah, we're very happy here with it. And before we start, it's very important to spread the word about this amazing system. And so please use the hashtag NEOS.com and share it. We did not start from the scratch. It's the first NEOS conference, the first official. But there have been a lot of great, great, amazing events in the past. And this is the reason why I'm calling Tobias on stage as an official part of the NEOS project and the core team to say some words about sponsoring badges and one special sponsor from the past.
Thank you, Sven. As you are, of course, aware, we've done a transformation this year from Inspiring Conference to NEOS Conference. But of course, NEOS Conference wouldn't be what we will see in the next 2 days without the legacy that we take from Tech Division, with the effort, the ideas that went into a great conference in the last 5 years. And so, what we want to do today is say thank you, and we are really grateful to take the honor of continuing this conference and to give our appreciation a physical item. What we've done as a team is we've created badges, a system of badges. This is one of the first incarnations, so to speak, for event organizers who put a lot of time and effort into organizing events like this. And I would like to ask Zepp from Tech Division on stage. Please give them a warm welcome. And it's my honor and my privilege to represent the NEOS team by saying thank you for not one, not two, not 5 years of awesome conferences in Kolbermoor. In the first year, it wasn't even Inspiring Conference yet. It was Flow 3 Experience. So in 2012, Tech Divisions organized the first Flow 3 Experience conference. Thank you very much. And then we had a transformation. It changed from Flow 3 Experience to Inspiring Conference 2013. Again, Tech Division was the organizer. And as you might guess, 2014, 2015, 2016, again, Zepp, thank you very much. Woo! And we hope that the next 2 days will be just as Inspiring Conference has been in the past, with a new name, NEOS Conference. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, stay in that mood to clap, because we have some more information for you, some organizing stuff. What could you expect from today? Of course, we want to continue the tradition of really great, amazing talks, like in the last years, and the quality increased each year, and we want to stay on this track. And you can vote for the talks. This is the reason for these wonderful colored papers. After each talk, there will be beautiful helping hands with a bucket, and you can put one of these papers in the bucket. And as you can imagine, like a traffic light, if you liked the talk, it was a really good and useful talk for you, then please throw a green one. If it was just regular, then yellow, and if you really disliked it, then a red one. And there are also pencils on your chair. That means it's really nice for the speaker if you have just a comment why you choose green or red. They love it a lot. And then we have a super intelligent, complicated system. And finally, after 2 days, the speaker will also receive an award. Please believe me, we really tried to find out a beautiful one, but that was not possible, and then we chose to make the bug to a feature, and so we chose the most ugliest one. I mean, it's glittering, but after choosing this award to the best speaker of the NEOS conference, I was sad that I am not doing a talk here today, because this would be very cool on my desk. I would love to have it. So this is very special for the speakers. Do not forget to vote for them. We will have case studies. This is the practical part and often very inspiring. And we will have lightning talks. As last year in Kolbomo, if you have been there, that means we will have 7 talks, and each talk is just 5 minutes. And I can tell you what the last sentence of each speaker will be. Ooh, 5 minutes is really short. This happened last year on almost every talk. And if you're not a speaker right now, but you want to be on this beautiful stage, this is your possibility. There is a white wall with the headline Lightning Talks, and there are papers, application forms. We just need the topic of your talk, your name, and then just pin it on that wall. The application is until the beginning of the lunch. Then we close the application period, and then everybody of you, and we trust you that you are not cheating or stuff like that, has one favorite. Just make a point, a dot, under this application form, and then the 7 ones with the most votes, that will be the lightning talks, what will we see later on. So, and then, again, the second time, in the evening, we will have the NEOS Award. And it's very interesting. I'm also very interested in who will win this award. And I thought, okay, this is easy because we are organizing it. I will know it. And I have to look, I have to prepare the slides. So, no, someone else is doing this part. So, I really don't know what will happen here. And but there has been a lot of applications for this award, and this is just a possibility to see how cool the increasement of NEOS, how bigger the websites, how bigger the brands, how more sexier the brands which use NEOS are, and this is really increasing in the last 12 months very, very much. And yeah, in the evening, in the night, we will have a social event. I mean, we are in Hamburg, and in which district it could be? It's in St. Pauli, and it's just a crossroad to the world-famous Reeperbahn, and this will be really a lot of fun. If you're a speaker, then it would be a good idea to do it on the first day, not on the second, but no, we can't change it anymore. Yeah, this this is what you can expect, but this wouldn't be possible without the supporters this event had, and it was really, really an amazing experience, because that was one of the most easier things. We have to invent new sponsor categories because they were full. I mean, that was really cool. And I want to say thank you for the value sponsors, Xpeer and TechDivision. And we have a Wi-Fi sponsor. This is Netlogix and Neos.com, Content's First Choice. Thank you very much. So many different categories. Our media partner is T3N. Tech sponsor is Screenus. They are doing the Twitter walls and other stuff. It's very cool. Ask them. And we have the Goodie Bag sponsor, and it's Internet. So thank you very much. And tonight we will have special sponsors for our social event. This is Gesagt Getan and One Drop. Thank you. And the t-shirt sponsor is Mindscreen, the beautiful t-shirt. Thank you. Yeah, Mindscreen, as you can read here in your neck. So, and then we have premium sponsors. And it's the most expensive category of sponsoring, and we have two slots for it, and it was the first category which was full. But the first one who said, okay, I will support it, was Sandstorm. Thank you very much. Maybe you know it already or not. There will be right now a live stream, YouTube live stream, and this live stream is organized and sponsored also by Sandstorm. Thank you very much for this. Yeah. The next premium sponsor is Punkt.de. Thank you. Yeah. And also premium, Flow Native, thank you. So, only four slots for this. That means the last premium sponsor, but also the same value added for this event. Thank you very much, network team. You have built also this wonderful launch area for the sun in the afternoon. Thank you. So, now the hands are warm. and the organizer of this event is Zeitgeist Neos Solutions. Yeah, thank you. one more thing. It was incredible, the support from the Neos Core team for this event. We are doing a lot of events, small events, medium events, and maybe this is the first really large one. But we have a lot of experience and support from the ecosystem, which is the topic of an event. And that was really incredible. That was the best and support we as an organizer ever got. Thank you very, very much to the core team. You can be very proud of your core team. That was great. Thank you. So, summer organizer stuff. There is a core color. I just declared this color as a core color. maybe you're a little bit jealous just having a white program on your lanyard or the other side is blue, but some of them have this shiny blue one. This is a possibility to recognize the members of the core team. If you want to ask them something or to drink a beer with them, these guys with this blue badge, this is the core team. And again, share everything what will happen right now. And with this hashtag, neos.com. Without, thank you, just a tag. I never tried it, it won't work. No, okay. yeah, spread the word, and I mean, it's fun. You will see it immediately on the social wall, and this is pretty cooler to do it that way. So this is the information stuff, and the thanks to the sponsors, all the organizational stuff. And so we can start with the first talk, with a keynote, and we're pretty good on time, and so have lots of fun with the first great talk.
Please welcome on stage Robert Lemke and Tobias Gruber.
Follow later on for the very exciting part as well. I'm so excited and I'm so happy to see all of you here because, yeah, as Sven already said, we went through a big transformation and now the NEOS team is so used to it already. I mean, can you imagine NEOS with a different logo or anything? It seems like it's really long ago, but it's just all that happened in such a short time, and now we're here at the NEOS conference. That's pretty cool. So this will be a little welcoming session to get you started, to get you updated on what happened during the last year, basically, and hopefully a bit of inspiration also about what we're going to do and maybe why we do that. But I'm really curious. So, who's here for the first time?
Well, everyone.
okay, no, not for NEOS conference, but I mean, including Inspiring conference. Raise your hand again. That's wow. That's more than a half, I guess. Yeah, that's pretty amazing. And who's not a developer? I mean, like. Really nice, yeah. We're getting there. Okay, so I'll probably ask you more stupid questions later on, but first, let's get back in time a bit and have a look at what happened during the last 11 months, basically. So last year, of course, was Inspiring Conference, and they set a high bar, especially in terms of food. I'm really curious how the food will turn out for this conference. I'm also curious, I don't know yet if there will be a cake. So let's see, it will be lots of surprises. And about this conference, we'll continue to go through a transformation, of course, also with the conference. I asked you who's not a developer. The idea of the NEOS conference, of course, is that this is the event in the year where everything NEOS comes together, everyone interested in NEOS, everyone working with NEOS. And so I think in the future, we'll also go further into that direction, that there are not only topics for developers, but also for other parts of the community. And that is also what happened with our sprints, for example. We don't call them code sprints anymore because it's not just about development, but we have marketing and other topics there as well. So I'm really excited about how that will continue to develop. Everyone used that photo. I think you'll see it multiple times in talks today and tomorrow, maybe, because it was really that exciting moment. And of course, that is one of the most significant things which happened only within the last 11 months. That is the launch of our brand. And that didn't just put a new face to Neos and Flow. It also was really an expression of our identity and helped the Neos team and many people involved to really feel at home in that family and live that new identity. Then we had a new brand guide, actually. Oh, by the way, if you are using the Neos logo, that has changed just slightly a bit. So if you're producing marketing material, then please go to github.com/neos/brand, where you see all the logos and also the brand guide, because the spacing between the N and Neos changed a bit, you know, refactoring. But as I said, this such a brand really means a lot to us. We see it used, being used everywhere, and people are proud to wear Neos items and so on. So, and also Florian from Sandstorm organized further material, swag, yeah, stickers, and many other things. And we want to give not just to give them away in big bags and everyone grabs them and so on, but we want to make sure that they are valuable to you, and we only want to produce stuff which makes sense, like not just to have giveaways for everyone. Right, and then we had actually 26 events in 2016. 26 Neos events. One of them was here in Nuremberg, as you see there, and we have meetups in so many places now, not only in German cities, but also in Austria and in Switzerland. So if you want to meet other Neos people closer to your hometown and discuss things like what do you do in your projects and things like that, then just go to a meetup. You find them on neos.io, or just start a new meetup. I really suggest that if you want to run a meetup, just get in touch with the Neos team or one of the meetup organizers, and they can give you a lot of tips how to start that and how to connect with other Neos people in your area. Another important format, event format for us, is Meet Neos, and that is this one-day event with talks, which is all about getting in touch with Neos, getting to know Neos. We had that in several cities. Also last year, it was in Munich, in Salzburg, and in Nuremberg. Anything else? I think that was it. And that is really helpful because it's really rather non-technical, and it allows people in that area to get a first idea about what you can do with Neos, and what others are doing with Neos. We show off some projects there. So if you want to help promoting Neos in your area, or maybe you know someone in some other country even, yeah, then get in touch with us. We can help setting that up, and we'll send some speakers. Tobias, right? No, we get there. We really love to do that. We also had our first Neos bar camp here in Hamburg on a nice houseboat. Actually, we considered just, you know, renting it for longer time, like for years. It's a good place for the Neos team. Had a nice terrace, and we could move around to other cities like Amsterdam. And so if you want to sponsor a houseboat for the Neos team, just get in touch with me. We also have some houseboat experience. We had a Neos sprint in Copenhagen on a houseboat, and we're walking very weirdly after that week. We also had a NEOS Dev Camp in Nuremberg and lots of sprints. Actually, we usually have about 4 NEOS sprints per year. This time it was in Dresden, in Hamburg, Nuremberg, Rosenheim, and just recently here in Hamburg. And this is a whole week usually of intensive working, and it's open to everyone. So if you want to contribute to NEOS or just to know how you can contribute, then feel free to join our next NEOS sprint. You usually find that information on discuss.neos.io, or we announce it on the website, or just write to hello@neos.io and just ask us what to do. Because that really helps us, not only in the development department, but also for marketing and other stuff. Right. We actually had a marketing sprint for the first time. And that was also very, very fruitful. So it was about NEOS, it was about the NEOS Award, NEOS newsletter, some agency listing on NEOS.io. So there are lots of topics currently being tackled by the Marketing Guild. And yeah, if you want to join there, just get in touch with them and help us getting better promoting NEOS, because it's one of the best kept secrets, as you know. Right, and we also see that the community grows, the team grows, we got new people in the team. This is not exactly the NEOS team, that was basically everyone participating in the sprint, or almost everyone participating in the sprint last week, this week. And one of the things we do there, of course, are releases, preparing releases and working on bigger stuff. Actually, we had 121 releases already for Flow and NEOS. And the most important ones last year, I mean, you can identify them by the login screen, since we actually released, which one was that? 2.2, right? Yeah, NEOS 2.2. There we introduced the new login screen, and since then we have changing wallpapers every time. I really like that. You kind of, yeah, that was the strawberry edition, remember? So we improved a lot there in terms of user experience and multi-site handling. Then we had the first long-term support version ever, NEOS 2.3. So there we concentrated, of course, on getting that stable for a long term. And we had some new asset management functionality. And if you don't know that yet, on neos.io you find a plan of all releases, also future releases, and how long they will be supported. So if you're not really keen on new features, you could use NEOS 2.3 until summer 2019. But why should you wait so long to upgrade? And then just recently we had NEOS 3.0, and Flow 4.0. And that was also important for us, because it finished kind of the transition to our new brand and identity. So we basically changed every line of code in Flow and NEOS to use the new vendor namespace. And the feedback we got so far was, even for me, surprising good, because, I mean, just consider that we really changed everything. The migration path was really smooth for most of the people, because we provide automatic scripts which adjust your code to the new version. That was quite an effort, but I think it was really worth it. And at the same point, we also made NEOS and Flow fit for PHP 7.1, which helps a lot for performance and, of course, future features and so on we can use in PHP. By the way, NEOS 3.0 is a PHP 7 only release. So you need PHP 7, and there's really no reason to not use PHP 7, of course. Honestly, PHP 5.6 won't be supported for very long anymore. I don't know, when does security patches run out? Like end of soonish, yeah. Soonish. I think that's about it. Yeah, soonish. And while we added and renamed things, we also renamed TypeScript to Fusion. So you can now do job offerings for Fusion engineers, you know. Sounds pretty attractive. We should print t-shirts with that, Fusion engineer. And we also moved all our issues to GitHub. Previously, that year before, we moved actually our code to GitHub, and then we also moved all the issues to GitHub. And that really helped us getting everything at one place and improve the workflow a lot. You also see actually that the rate of issues being solved or pull requests being solved has improved a lot compared to the previous years. So I think this whole GitHub workflow really helped us getting better at keeping that overview of how everything works there. And then we made a big announcement last year. I don't know if you remember that. We just said, yeah, Neos needs something new on the JavaScript side. So we just said, how about completely creating a new user interface based on React? So you'll hear more about that later in some other talks, but that was really a big move, and we just started doing that. And yeah, I think there'll be dedicated talk in the end from the labs. Oh no, from the labs actually will be about event sourcing stuff, right? So, but you'll see later what happened with that experiment. And the From the Labs thing is a workshop we had with Matthias Ferres, who also be here this afternoon giving a talk. And there we we asked him to challenge our ideas about creating a new content repository based on event sourcing and some other techniques. Or command sourcing in that case even. And that is really some crazy stuff. And if you want to know more about it, there will be a talk tomorrow, which is kind of from the labs, explaining that a bit. But the idea behind it is that we have so many ideas for features which currently cannot be implemented with a regular content repository approach. And also, we want to make it faster and stabilize it. Certain operations are difficult to handle. And also, we want to be able to modularize it. So if you want to split up Neos into different services, run some microservice approach for certain parts, all that will be much easier if we are dealing with events. And this will be the wallpaper for the new Neos release, 3.1. And actually, that is a photo also taken by one of the Neos team members, like some of the previous as well. So Neos 3.1 will be released
soonish,
says the same guy. So it's basically, yes, it depends a bit on the party, I think, tonight. If it's really boring, then maybe tonight, but anyway, so pretty soon. So we keep our schedule there. And I love the new login screen. So yeah, that was about what happened during the last 11 months. And I had to actually leave out a couple of things, of course. And then there was some other thing which we announced last year. And that is what Tobias will tell you about. Tobias.
Thank you. As you know by now, all good things with Neos take a bit. But in the end, we come up with a really great solution that will hopefully work for a lot of years and will make life easier for everyone in the community. I have a short slot today to talk about the Neos Foundation, and I want to use this time to give you an overview of what we're doing, where we stand, what our ideas are, and what you can expect from that in the future. So the first thing that you notice when we're talking about a legal entity that we want to create for NEOS is that we want to give it the name NEOS Foundation. We want to make clear this is a legal entity that is designed to support the NEOS ecosystem, the NEOS community. It's not meant to be a for-profit company that makes a lot of money and the core team gets rich or anything. And the main point really is it will be NEOS Foundation CIC Community Interest Company. Now, most of you have probably never heard about the Community Interest Company. What is that? When we looked at the different forms of legal entities we could choose for a NEOS company or a NEOS association or a NEOS whatever, we really thought hard about which restrictions will we have to face and which opportunities can we receive from that. And during our search, I think, Robert, you found something from a guy. In the UK, there's a concept called the Community Interest Company, and we thought, hey, a company that works in the interest of the community, isn't that exactly what we're looking for, to support the community and still be able, as the legal entity, to do all the things that we want to and not be restricted by having to spend all our money because we're not able to take money over to the next year or having to declare that and everything. And we looked into that in detail and we found out, wow, this concept really has big advantages for us. So the first thing, community interest is in its name, and that's regulated by the regulator in the UK. So when we wrote up the registration documents, I had to write down what will we do for the community, what will be the exact activities be, how do we do that, what do we plan to do with the money, what do we do if we make extra money, what do we do with it? And they want to know that to verify that the legal entity we're creating really works in the interest of the community. And so we basically wrote down everything that Robert just said, right? We want to do events, we want to promote the brand, we want to do sprints. We want to develop, we want to make sure NEOS is a really great CMS and Flow is a great application framework, and we want to promote that in the future. Another really cool thing about this is everything is in English. It's not a German entity, and for legal reasons, every document has to be in German, but then, what do the people from everywhere else do with that? No, it's English only, it's from the start English, and everybody can look at it, read it, and no translation needed. A really big reason why we are creating a company in the first place, you might ask, hey, you've done that for 2 years now, I think, without any legal entity. Yeah, the biggest issue really is we want to have a neutral place to raise funds for the NEOS community, the NEOS team, work on NEOS done by the core team. Currently, we as Sandstorm are somewhat proxying that, and if you're a long-term supporter, if you've bought a sprint badge, you really have to trust us at the moment that, you're buying something from Sandstorm, and we promise we will use the money for NEOS. And that's not really what it should be like, right? You should buy it from the NEOS Foundation, CIC, and the money that goes in there will only be used for NEOS purposes, period. And that's exactly what we can do with a community interest company. A specialty, it has something that's called an asset lock. So money that goes in cannot be taken out easily. It always stays with the company. So even if by magical happenings in the future, we get a lot of supporters and we make a lot of money, the members of that company can just say, hey, that's cool, I'll retire with that money. It's not possible. We cannot take it out. We can only spend it for the purposes we have set out, which is to support the community. A core concept that we implement with the NEOS Foundation is, the question is, of course, who owns that company, right? It's basically a limited based in the UK, so it has members that own the company. And we thought really hard, okay, how do we do that? And the idea was, we want people in control of our legal entity who really, really care about NEOS and NEOS in the first place. So the first and, you know, group of people that came to mind that it really makes sense is, okay, let's look at the core team. Those guys spend free time, company time, sleepless nights on sprints to work on NEOS and bring it forward. So yeah, that makes sense. Let's think about having the core team as members of that company. And then we thought, okay, we know from experience that with when once you get into such a position to be a member of the company, you may, you know, your focus may shift away from NEOS, but you're still a member of that company and you sit there and you're not really interested in NEOS maybe anymore because of shifting priorities, which is okay. So we introduced something which we called active team members. So we want everyone who is an active team member in the core team, and that's completely separate from the legal entity, to be a team member. And then to be an active team member. And when you're an active team member, you automatically are invited to become a member of the NEOS Foundation. And when you're not active, you drop out. And that's also an automatic process, right? So the NEOS Foundation CIC, once we've incorporated that, will be run by people who have an active interest in NEOS and are team members. So we ensure that the NEOS Foundation keeps true to its purpose to act in the interest of the NEOS community. And the last thing I want to share, we're still in the process of incorporating. There's some bureaucracy going on, but it should be finished in the next weeks, hopefully. We've cleared a lot of steps on the way already. With the NEOS Foundation CIC, we're upgrading our supporters. So from the funding platform you know right now, there's bronze, silver, and gold levels. We will transition that, of course, the complete funding to the NEOS Foundation. And we've thought about, okay, what do we want to recognize as a team? What is, you know, important? And what is valuable, really? And Florian and the team of designers and, you know, created these new badges. You saw me hand out the physical ones earlier to Tech Division. So depending on the level, we've come up with a system when you receive a physical one, a digital one, and other benefits attached to it. So we want to recognize active team member employers who sponsor company time for team members. We have the long-time supporters, and we will introduce new levels on top of gold, platinum, and diamond, and that will come this year, probably. Core feature sponsors, something that hasn't happened too often in the past, but we want to make this clear again. If a company really wants a feature for NEOS to be created and to be created in the core, and sponsors that development effort, of course we will recognize it. It's the greatest thing that can happen, right? That a new cool feature is introduced into NEOS because someone really wants it. Event organizers, that's the one I've handed out earlier. And then there's the one-time supporters, and we've got new badges for that as well. As I said, those will be available soonish. Florian asked me, last thing really, to mention where the swag is. It's outside. There's a little collection box at the registration desk. Okay, so the swag that Robert talked about earlier, you can find it there. And we have a little box where you can say, hey, I really like that, and it's valuable to me, and you leave a little bit of money for us so that you don't just take the stuff and drop it in the next trash can when the event is over. So should you have any further questions regarding the NEOS Foundation, just, you know, come up to me and ask me. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Tobias. That was the long process, and I'm really looking forward to getting that or letting that become reality very soon. I know that you are eagerly waiting on the actual stuff about NEOS and Flow, all the details and so on. But I have to, you have to go through the next couple of minutes still because I want to get into some meta topic. Even though the NEOS Foundation CIC will be something like a company technically, but you know now know that it's a community interest company, NEOS clearly is not a company. It's still an open source project, right? And that means it also works with other rules. We don't employ people. We don't we don't expel people. We can't order features. You know, we provide the best we can do. A lot of us in the spare time, and only by that we are able to produce such a great software and everything which is related to it. And with the NEOS Foundation, how did that happen? Like it's someone like there shall be a NEOS Foundation. It was basically like that, yeah, right? Of course. And why did it take so long? So there's actually, especially for the NEOS Foundation, there's a reason why it took so long. It was not, we were so busy and just didn't make it. We didn't want to give in to that impulse that now that we are on our own, a new open source project, that we just start a new NEOS Association or whatever. We wanted to know why we're actually doing that. And we wanted to find out. And there was one situation this week. We had a one-day NEOS team retrospective led by Gina. And we went through all kinds of different topics. And one of them, where we ended up in a fishbowl, which is a really nice format for discussing things, was about exploring other markets. And then, of course, we thought like, yeah, of course, NEOS needs to be spread into all markets, and we want to conquer the US. So, world domination, you know? So, we need to develop the US market because it's a key market and so on. And so we started to discuss what would it take and what do we have to do and things like that. And it was kind of a funny situation. I think it was Sebastian sitting there in that fishbowl and me as well, and I asked why. And then I think Sebastian said like, yeah, because and so, and then yeah, and why that? And you know that stuff, right? When you ask a couple of times why, you end up either on money or sometimes you don't know why. Actually, it's like we need to start a foundation. We need to take venture capital. We should use React because it's a really cool framework. We need to do event sourcing because, you know, we can. but I think it's important to know why. Everything else is cargo cult, right? Because others are doing that, and you probably know that during World War II era there was this military base, and the people living there had never seen a plane, of course, but they helped the Americans and got some nice sweets and everything in return. And when they left, they started cherishing planes, worshipping planes as gods, because they just wanted to repeat that. They thought like maybe something like that will land again here and the Swedes will come back. So they were just repeating that. So it doesn't make sense if we just do like the others do without knowing why. And So I asked myself, or we asked ourselves at that point also, why the original team met and started NEOS in the first place was a whole different thing than usually you have in an open source project, because it was not something we could use right away. It was clear that it would take a lot of time until there's a product we could use. So the motivation to get together was something else. It was challenge, it was people wanting to get together to create something great they couldn't do in their day-to-day projects. And there was something like between the lines. And so often during that all these years, we have, of course, that question, what should we do next? Which feature should we create next? We have, fortunately, limited resources, because that also puts a constraint and focuses on, lets us focus on what's really meaningful. And if the goal was just like, NEOS is the world's used, most used, still a typo there, but not three. the most used content platform, so that would be flattering, right? That would be pretty cool, because we would be very important. I would be very important as well. You know? And then, what would we do next when we reached that goal? And what for? Expand to space, yeah. Okay, that's always... So, okay, the original team who started NEOS had and have a vision for NEOS. What to achieve, and also especially how to achieve that. The thing is, it's not always clear how that vision looks like, because it's also not very clear to each of us all the time. So it's partially implicit. But now that we are at the point where we are growing the team more and more, we really need to transfer that to everyone else, because the people who are in the team for a very long time know how to work with each other and how to go into the right direction. So what we really need, and what we need to go through, is a process to find the true north, to find the big picture. So we also have some ideas how we are going to do that. So basically what we want to do is each one of the people who are in the team for quite some time will sit down and probably write up some part of their vision, write that down, and we probably publish that as articles on our website. And then when we have all these articles together, we can distill something which eventually becomes the true north. So NEOS and Flow are doing certain things in a very specific way. And I mean, we encourage people to write clean code. We introduce test-driven development, domain-driven design, basically since 2006. And that was long before someone really started using DDD and PHP. That was, but so we promote all these techniques and also tell people to not deploy with FTP, have a proper deployment pipeline. Who's deploying with FTP? You do. So we do all that. Yeah, and of course it's not coincident. It's also not to show how cool we are and what complicated techniques we all learned. It's because we are convinced that these techniques allow you to create better work, that these techniques make it easier for you in your work, that these techniques simplify your work, that they provide value to you and your customers, that they actually get your job done in a better way. So hopefully for you also to create something more meaningful, because doing something meaningful or leaving a legacy is, I mean, who has kids? Like, is that age currently? Like, you know, we're getting older.
people think about, am I doing the right thing, still doing websites? And that's a universal need. It's all about purpose. And I looked up a very old book I read together with someone you probably know, Kasper Skorhøy, some many years ago, 2003 or so, I think, we discussed that. And there's two books, basically, and this one is called The Eighth Habit. And there's the whole person paradigm with mind, body, heart, and spirit. That's a whole person. And the four needs of a person, which is to learn, to live, to love, to leave a legacy. And the inner part, to leave a legacy, that is what Stephen Covey calls the voice, your voice, finding your voice. And if you achieve that, if you found your voice, you can start to inspire others finding their voice. And I see your faces. Okay, nice, but my customers didn't order that. I need to get that damn website finished. I know. So why does it matter? I don't know. How easy is it to get a good new developer employed? Very easy, right? On the trees. They grow on trees. So this is the old, from industrial age, the approach to manage people like things. You know that, right? In the middle is the boss, the leader knows best and makes all decisions. And nobody needs to know what's about the future. They just need to follow the rules, be efficient, and, you know. I think there are still a lot of agencies and other organizations working that way. And we get in touch with a lot of agencies who work that way still. But that results in certain pain for individuals and the organization. So, and what's in the middle, and that is about that purpose and meaning thing, is the low trust. And eventually, I mean, also disempowerment, you know, like they have ideas, but you don't let them. By the way, there's a very nice podcast in German called Das Perfekte Team.de by Christian Müller, which is about that topic. You didn't know that, right? So, I think we really try, and sometimes consciously and sometimes not, to inspire you guys to do something meaningful. I don't know, really be honest, and just don't do me a favor. Who felt inspired during his work with Flow or Neos, not just like on a technical way, but like it changed something for you? Is there someone? So that is actually some side effect, something we also want to achieve, right? So this is kind of the positive model for it. So for example, I think we're pretty good at the heart area there, empowering. In the Neos team, for example, when you're part of the Neos team, there is no difference between other team members. You have full power to take part in all the decisions. You can kill every server you like. You have all credentials for that. Because we trust you. When you made it to become a team member, then we trust you like everyone else. So we try to empower you. And I think we can be a bit better with the pathfinding and modeling part, because we sometimes struggle with investing time into onboarding new people. I think we are very friendly and we do spend time, but I think because we don't know very clearly the path ourselves and we haven't written down the true north, it's sometimes difficult to be a model there. So anyway, What I want to say is, after all, it's not just about creating that great software or have great events or be the most successful CMS in the world. But I think if we know why we do that, that is exactly what can happen. So the outcome might be the same, and we'll be the most widespread CMS on this planet. But first, I think we need to take that detour and know why we want to do that. So I wish you a very, very inspiring conference, and that you find, maybe you see it somewhere in some of the talks, some little glimpse of some true north of NEOS. Thank you. We have a quick